Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Nidhi Garg from Deshbandhu College, University of Delhi. Today, we are going to talk on module Comparative Genomics from the paper Molecular Genetics. After studying this module, you will be able to know the overview of genome sequencing and major genome projects, comparative genomic analysis of prokaryotes and eukaryotes, followed by an understanding of the significance of comparative genomics. Comparative genomics is an evolving field of biological and computational science whereby researchers use a variety of bioinformatic tools to perform computer-based analysis and compare the genome sequences of different organisms, either prokaryotes or eukaryotes. The computer-based analysis provides an insight into the genomes of these organisms with an aim to predict regions of similarities or differences. This information thus helps in better understanding of the structure and function of organisms in context with the human health. The use of bioinformatic tools in studying these genomes has immensely advanced our knowledge to understand the inherited potential of these organisms. Apart from the similarity and differences, the researchers always emphasize on the novel information possessed by the organism, and it is made possible only when multiple genomes of different organisms are compared. The first comparative genomic analysis was performed way back in 1986 by comparing the genomes of varicella zoster virus and Epstein-Barr virus, which harbors around 100 genes. Since then, the advancement in sequencing technology has led to the comparative genomic analysis of thousands of genomes. It is now feasible to sequence the entire genome of an organism and study those attributes which are helpful for predicting the changes that can be fatal for the organism and thus can be treated before the onset of the trait. For survival, each and every organism undergoes evolutionary changes to combat the environmental stress. But the evolution occurs at a slow pace, and thus several regions in the genome are conserved throughout the phylogenetic hierarchy. Few of these genes are related to the human system, so comparative genomics provides an edge for studying the mechanism of evolution. By considering this, it becomes easier to understand the mechanism or force behind the evolutionary processes. So far, several genome projects have been undertaken worldwide and successfully accomplished. Some of these I will be discussing in the first genome to be sequenced was of a bacteriophage named as MS2 by Fiers et al. Way back in 1976. It had a genome size of 3,569 base pairs and had only 4 coding sequences. The second genome to be sequenced was by Sanger et al. In 1977 of PhyX-174, which had again a small genome size of 5,386 base pair and had 11 coding sequences. The simian virus 40 was sequenced again by Fiers et al. In 1978, which had a genome size of the size similar to PhyX-174 of 5,224 base pairs with 8 coding sequences. The first so-called eukaryotic portion of the genome that was sequenced was of a chloroplast genome belonging to the organism Nicotina tobacum. The chloroplast genome contained genes that coded for 4 rRNAs, 30 tRNAs, 39 proteins, and 11 other predicted sequences which might be coding for certain proteins. The first free living genome to be sequenced was of Haemophilus influenzae by Fleischmann et al. In 1995, which had 1657 coding sequences. The next genome to be sequenced was of Mycoplasma genitalium by Fraser et al. Again in 1995, which had 470 coding sequences. The first eukaryotic genome to be sequenced was of yeast, known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae by Goffo et al., which had some 5,885 coding sequences and a genome size of 12,000 base pairs. Escherichia coli strain K12 was the next to be sequenced by Blattner et al. In 1997. It had some 4,288 protein coding sequences. The first multicellular organism to be sequenced was Caenorhabditis elegans, or a cute roundworm. It was sequenced in the year 1998 and had a genome size of 97 MB and had over 19,000 protein coding sequences. The next multicellular organism to be sequenced was Drosophila melanogaster in the year 2000, which had a genome size of 137 MB and had approximately 13,500 coding sequences. Rhabdopsis thaliana, or the mustard plant, was the next to be sequenced in the year 2000, which had a genome size of 125 MB and had 25,000 protein coding sequences. The genome, the human genome, was sequenced in the year 2001 and its final draft was submitted in the year 2003. The human genome at that time was said to have about 30,000 to 40,000 protein coding sequences, the number which has drastically reduced to about 20,000 protein coding sequences as of now. Methods for genome sequencing and assembly. The first ever nucleic acid sequence was generated by Hawley et al. Way back in 1965 of an alanine tRNA molecule from yeast after treating the purified tRNA with a series of ribonucleases. After this, in 1970, Ray Wu developed a method for extension of DNA nucleotide sequences based on primer sequences. Then, the first ever sequencing method was introduced by Maxim and Gilbert in the year 1977, which was known as the Maxim-Gilbert's method or the chemical cleavage method. The method was based on four separate chemical cleavage reactions followed by gel electrophoresis profiling of DNA of interest. Methods for genome sequencing assembly. In 1975, the didioxy chain terminating sequencing was developed by Frederick Sanger, which involves the use of fluorescently labeled chain terminating nucleotides, hence widely known as the chain terminator method. The progress of this method over the Maxim-Gilbert method led to the introduction of the Human Genome Project in the year 1990, which was completed 2 years earlier than the scheduled project of 2003. The development of second generation sequencing technologies completely changed the scenario of DNA sequencing. The first SGS technology was spirosequencing, founded by Pal Niren in 1990. It was based upon the principle of sequence by synthesis. This method was further improvised by 454 Life Science Technologies by giving it better results in terms of reads per run. By 2006, the Solexa Genome Analyzer was developed with a holding capacity to deliver sequences in gigabases per run, and in the next year it was acquired by Illumina. By the end of 2010, there were several new sequencing technologies that were commercialized, such as sequencing by oligonucleotide ligation and detection, which in short is known as SOLID, and others like Illumina HiSeq and MiSeq with improved read length, throughput and accuracy. This has expanded the public repository database to an extent, but more with draft genome entries rather than whole genome sequences. This has built up the expectations from the sequencing technologies to expand the horizon of complete genome sequences in the public databases. The advent of third-generation sequencing technologies by the end of 2010 was a breakthrough in an endeavor of developing improvised technologies. The major advantages here were higher accuracy, higher throughput, longer read lengths, and no amplification biases, which was also followed by faster runtime, low DNA quantity, low cost. Even a complete human genome is now costing less than $100. Wow, what an advancement. Nanopore technologies and PAC biosciences are the main sequencing techniques in third generation techniques. The ion torrent and helicase are in transition between the second generation sequencing or the third generation sequencing because of two main reasons. The ion torrent has improvised in terms of simplifying the sequencing processes, runtime, and cost, but are still amplification based, whereas the helicase has all the characteristics of the third generation sequencing but have low read length and runtime. Hence, these emerging sequencing techniques lay the basis for improvement in DNA sequencing and public database expansion for researchers. In order to generate the contigs from the reads, a wide variety of assemblers are used, such as ABISIS, Velvet, Ray, Mira, etc. These assemblers align and merge the individual reads to generate a contig or a set of contigs. During this process, the error in assembly occurs because of adding of the fragments at the wrong places or incorrectly discard of fragments or repeats. To overcome these difficulties, one should select an assembler based on their sequencing method, sequence quality, and the assembler with lower error rates. Genome annotation and comparative genomic analysis. Now, this process consists of several steps, which begins with the process of genome sequencing. Now, once the genome has been sequenced, the next step involves genome assembly, where the reads are combined to form contigs. The contigs are further combined to form scaffolds, which together needs to form the complete chromosome or the genome. After genome assembly, the next step is CDS prediction, followed by pathway prediction, and followed by comparative genomic analysis. The comparative genomic analysis involves three major things. The first being the general genome comparison, which involves comparison of the normal attributes or features of the genome. The second step involves phylogenetic analysis, while the third step involves functional genomics. After assembly, the genomes are annotated into protein coding sequences, and thereafter, further annotations are carried out. Some of the easily accessible tools for genome annotations are listed below. One of which is NCBI Prokaryotic Genome Annotation Pipeline, known as PGAP. The next is RAST, which is the Rapid Annotation Using Subsystem Technology. ResFinder 2.1 is the Acquired Antimicrobial Resistant Gene Finder. Another such software is Cluster of Orthologs, known as COG Analysis, followed by OrthoMCL and the KEG Automatic Annotation Server, known as CAS. The NCBI Prokaryotic Genome Annotation Pipeline, or the PGAP. This pipeline completely annotates the bacterial genome and provides sequence submission file. The pipeline provides or predicts the protein coding sequences as well as the non-coding RNAs, which are of quite importance these days. The annotation provides nucleotide, genbank, and amino acid FASTA files along with the pseudogenes, etc. The Rapid Annotation Using Subsystem Technology, or the RAST. This is a fully automated server for archaeal and bacterial genome annotation. It provides several different types of file formats such as FNA, FAA, GBK for further genome analysis. It also classifies the gene into different subsystems. The tRNA Scan SE. It is an efficient tool for predicting copies of tRNA along with its secondary structure. The ResFinder 2.1, it identifies the antimicrobial resistant genes from complete or draft genomes. The next important software, which is the Cluster of Orthologs Analysis, is a database annotation of orthologs cluster and functional annotation. OrthoMCL. It is a database for grouping proteins into ortholog clusters based on sequence similarity. The KEG Automatic Annotation Server, or the CAS, this server functionally annotates the genes using BLAST or GHOST search against the manually curated KEG gene database. The resultant file contains KO, that is the keg orthology identifier, which is visualized for pathway in IPath server. Steps for comparative genomic analysis in prokaryotes. The following are the three major steps which are followed by a researcher for comparing the genomes of different organisms in case of prokaryotes. The first is the determination or the comparison of the general genomic attributes, followed by phylogenetic analysis, and then finally carrying out the functional genomics. The first step for comparative genomic analysis in prokaryotes involves the general genomic attribute comparison. Here, the general genomic attributes, which includes the genome size, the number of coding sequences, the percentage GC content, pseudogenes, number and types of RNAs, source of isolation, etc., are compared between different prokaryotic genomes. This information provides an overall basis on which the complete study is based. The similarity and differences can be compared with the environment and the type of selection pressure existing in the particular environment. The second step for comparative genomic analysis in prokaryotes involves the phylogenetic analysis. The molecular phylogeny provides insight into the evolutionary relationship among a group of organisms, either from same genus or belonging to different genera. This method analyzes the sequence variation that occurs in nucleotide or amino acid sequence, based on which phylogenetic tree is constructed. The phylogenetic tree is a graph consisting of branches and nodes built on a single marker gene, such as the 16S rRNA gene, or it may be comprising of a set of genes like the single copy genes, or maybe about the complete genome. There are several ways to construct the phylogenetic tree, but the five principal methods for tree construction are the distance-based methods, like the neighbor joining method, or the method may be based on statistical approach like the maximum likelihood method. The method may be based on character like the maximum parsimony method, or it may be a statistical based approach like the Bayesian inference. Some of the easily accessible and user-friendly softwares for phylogenetic construction are MEGA, which stands for Molecular Genetic Evolutionary Analysis, followed by PhyLIP, that is the Phylogeny Inference Package, the MayBIOS, and the POP, which is the phylogenetic analysis using parsimony. The figure here shows a phylogenetic tree which has been constructed using the 16S rRNA sequence, showing the three major domains of life, where the organisms have been grouped into three major groups: the bacteria, the archaea, and the eukaryota, originating from a common ancestor. Functional genomics. Now, functional genomic studies aim to understand the relationship between the genotypic and the phenotypic repertoire of an organism. For this, the genomic sequences are first annotated against a database for functional annotation. The information thus obtained is used to build the pathway maps. The analysis also reveals the novelty possessed by the organism using comparative view, that is the strain-specific traits. The figure here shows the functional profiling of 9 Sphingobium genomes. The coding sequences of the 9 genomes were annotated against the Cas server. Further, the assigned KO was used to construct the minimal set of pathways using the MinPath. Few of the user-friendly online servers for functional genomics are OrthoMCL, which used for identification of ortholog groups for eukaryotic genomes, the KEG, which is the Cas server used for KEG orthology annotation. Based on this information, metabolic pathways are constructed. The Interactive Pathways Explorer V2, which is an online tool available for analysis and visualization of metabolic pathways, regulatory pathways, and pathway for biosynthesis of secondary metabolites. The MinPath, or the minimal set of pathways. It is a software which uses parsimony approach for biological pathway reconstruction using assigned KO annotation. The non-synonymous synonymous ratio. Now, genes from different organisms are compared to analyze the direction of evolution. The analysis is performed using softwares and servers like HiFi and DataMonkey. The synonymous and the non-synonymous substitution ratio are predicted after comparing the two DNA sequences with DS and NS as the number of synonyms and the non-synonymous substitutions per site respectively. Thus, the ratio, which is known as the mega, which is DN by DS, measures the change between the two rates. Now, if an amino acid is neutral, it will be fixed with the same rate as a synonymous mutation. Hence, the value of omega would be equal to 1. While, if the amino acid change is deleterious, purifying selection would reduce its fixation rate. Hence, omega would be less than 1. Only when the amino acid change offers a selective advantage, it will be fixed at a higher rate than a synonymous mutation. Hence, omega would be greater than 1. Therefore, an omega ratio significantly higher than 1 suggests diversifying natural selection. Comparative genomic analysis in eukaryote. Now, the eukaryote genomes vastly differ in their genome size and coding density in comparison to the prokaryotic genomes. The basic genome annotation, therefore, remains similar to the prokaryotic genomic study. The differences lie in the approach opted for the study. As for example, in order to compare them, instead of counting the number of genes, gene families can be considered. The genomes can be analyzed for the presence of paralogs and orthologs. These studies can then be computed using the BLAST algorithm. The comparison between yeast, fruit fly and worms may reveal those proteins which are absent in yeast but that are only present in the multicellular organisms. Those protein families which are specific to fruit fly may be responsible for immune system development. The study can be extended to analyze the domains, the domain combination in different organisms as these domains appear in different combination in different proteins. Further analysis can be performed based on hypothesis. The table here shows the comparison of compactness of eukaryotic genomes with respect to gene density. There is a comparison between the three genomes, the three eukaryotic genomes rather, that is between the one that is yeast, known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae, between Drosophila melanogaster and the Homo sapiens. Here, the gene density is highest in case of the yeast, the one with the smallest genome. Another thing is that the introns per gene is highest in the Homo sapiens with 9 introns per average. Now, the amount of the genome taken up by the genome-wide repeats or the repeated sequences are maximum in the Homo sapiens. The table here shows a comparison of genes, gene families, and the number of duplicates along the prokaryotic and the eukaryotic species. 4 organisms have been compared, which involves the Haemophilus influenzae, the eukaryote yeast, the Drosophila melanogaster and the C. elegans, where we observe that in terms of total number of genes, there is a sequential increase in the size in the number of genes as the complexity of the genome increases. Also, there is an increase in the number of gene families from 1400 to 9400, beginning Haemophilus influenzae to C. elegans. Also, the number of duplicates has significantly increased from 300 in Haemophilus influenzae to C. elegans, where there are 9,000 duplicates of genes. The comparative studies have already uncovered the following facts. For example, a study has demonstrated that about 60% of genes of Drosophila and humans are conserved. Apart from this, the study also suggests that 2/3 of human genes which are involved in cancer have homologs in Drosophila. Thus, Drosophila is being used as a model organism for several human-related disorders such as neurodegenerative diseases. The researchers have shown comparison of nearly 50 bird species genomes that has revealed a gene network that triggers singing in birds and can play an important role in human speech and language. In order to increase the food production, several comparative studies have been performed Once a study on milk production has revealed a set of genes that increase the yield of high-fat milk in cows, resulting in high levels of milk production. Researchers have found mutations in myostatin gene that is known to increase two-fold muscling in cattle. This can be implemented to increase muscle mass of other meat animals such as sheep, goat, pig, chicken, turkey, and fish. So students, let's summarize what we have learned in this module. The current chapter elucidates the basic methodology opted for comparative genomic analysis. The most important criteria for comparative genomics is data generation. Therefore, the use of sequencing method becomes an integral part to devise the overall study. The field of genome sequencing is changing day by day, thus it is advisable to be updated with the new upcoming techniques. The first sequencing method was introduced by Maxim and Gilbert way back in 1977, known as the Maxim-Gilbert's method. The second method to be developed was dideoxin chain terminating sequencing by Frederick Sanger in 1975, which was highly preferred over Maxim-Gilbert's method and led to the introduction of the Human Genome Project in 1990, which was completed 2 years ahead of its scheduled project in 2003. These techniques were the first generation sequencing technologies. The second generation sequencing technologies completely changed the scenario of DNA sequencing. The first such second generation sequencing technology was pyrosequencing, founded by Pal Nyren in 1990, which was based upon the principle of sequencing by synthesis. This technique was also further improvised by the 454 Life Sciences. In 2006, the Solexa Genome Analyzer was developed, which had a holding capacity to deliver sequences in gigabases per run, and in the next year it was acquired by Illumina. By the end of 2010, there were several new sequencing techniques commercialized, such as sequencing by oligonucleotide ligation and detection, known as SOLID, Illumina HiSeq and MiSeq, which had improved read length, throughput, and accuracy. This was followed by the development of third generation sequencing techniques, such as the nanopore technologies and the PAC biosciences, whereas the ion torrent and the helicase are still in transition between the second and the third generation sequencing technologies. Apart from sequencing methodology, tools for genomic analysis are also changing and newer tools are coming into existence. Therefore, it is recommended to use new tools for performing the comparative studies as it helps in depth analysis with more informative results. The availability of the genomes and their annotation and comparative analysis enhances the overall usefulness of the organism, which might either be a eukaryote or a prokaryote. The researchers are increasingly using comparative genomics to elucidate the microbial diversity to develop as a human pathogen. These studies also uncover the evolution of microbes and hosts in terms of their behavioral pattern, metabolism, and susceptibility, act as pathogens or to get infected. Thank you.